Welcome to the 1973 Jensen Interceptor. Now, the only reason that I even know about this car is from my good buddy Howard. It's his birthday. He's turning 93, I believe. So for his birthday, I wanted to do a tribute to one of the coolest things that he ever brought to my attention. We have a big passion for cars, and I did not know anything about this car until he showed me. And this is maybe one of the most underrated cars and unknown cars to all car enthusiasts. Those of you that do know about this car, I apologize. But for those of you that don't, this is an amazing machine. This is a Italian design car built in England with American muscle under the hood. Now, this is a steel body. I did make the mistake and say that it is fiberglass. It is not fiberglass. This is a steel body with a Chrysler 440 big block in here. This little tiny car will move. It's an amazingly designed car. Inside has that beautiful English engineering with the wood grain that I can totally see why Howard fell in love with this car, because it is astonishing. I think his was even nicer looking, the black, but this is a very nice exception to the Jensen family. I mean, this color looks nice. It's just a really nice car. Most of the ones that you'll see are convertibles. I am not a convertible person, as I've said before. This is a hard top. His was a hard top. And I mean, the sound of the big block is just amazing. And Howard's was even nicer. It had louvered hood so that the heat could come out a little bit better, and it also had some different exhaust, which sounded really nasty. This one sounds really good, but it definitely doesn't have that grunt that Howard's had. The interior is just tastefully done, and this car drives awesome. Totally see why he fell in love with it. So I thought for his birthday I would just share this with him and with all of my fans, this amazing ride. So happy birthday to Howard, and happy birthday to anybody who's ever had one of these. I definitely have to add this to my bucket list. I would love to have one of these one day. So here it is, 1973 all over again.
Last leg.
That's why we need to do one shot.